first day on the job. I gotta meet Elaine. Hey, Elaine, what's up? Host! Elaine!
I can't believe I let this happen.
Man, fuck! Man, I can't believe I let that happen in LA. What's wrong with me?
She wakes up. There's nothing I can do right now. I guess I have to be there for her.
Hey, what's good, classmates and the instructor? You know, what you guys just watched was the environment of the city of San Francisco. And in the other video, I was reacting Chad's reaction, especially after the accident. And he blames himself. So he's at the hospital. He punches a wall and then he goes sits down. And grabs his hair, says a couple lines, and yo, what's going on? It's Brian from your class, yo. Apparently I'm gonna talk about the project. Story about chatting on Lane. Just, you know, normal teenagers trying to live their life, trying to figure out what they're actually gonna do with their life. But apparently, Chad has his first job, so he's gonna meet Elaine, because Elaine got him a job. You know, to work as a lab assistant. So in the big city where they're at, he's getting off BART to go meet Elaine. And then a sudden when he saw Elaine, she's waving him down, you know. Chad's always acting cool and stuff, walking up and stuff. She's waving him down and a sudden an explosion happens, you know, from the actual floor that her father actually works at. This is supposed to be as big day, his big opportunity to start his new job and stuff, but all of a sudden, you know, outrageous disaster, bomb, explosion, it's crazy. This is in the city. What is actually going on? So apparently her dad was having an experience, I guess they went wrong accidentally, so it caused a problem. Everybody's running for their lives. Elaine passed out because of the big explosion, dramatic. So Chad, in this scene, we're gonna explain the action and expression in his face. He's like, oh my god, what am I gonna do? So the first thing that comes to mind is go get his friend Elaine. She's all passed out because of the explosion. He's like, oh, shocked, like, oh my god. So he goes, runs towards her, you know, pick her up, trying to get her out of the explosion. As soon as he picks her up, a big wave that hits everybody that's around them. Big wave of fog. For some reason, it just passed through the city of that part, you know? And then all of a sudden, you know, they're stuck. And then, so they both pass out. Yeah, of course, they got helped and stuff, you know? Everybody got a rescue team. But, anyways, with this video, that's pretty much what happened. You know, they're stuck in the hospital. But apparently, Elaine's mom works in the hospital, but she put them on a separate floor, privacy. You know, because her daughter's in a coma, and she's family friends with Chad and his family. So, right now, they're just like resting. It took, Chad recovered. He only had a couple ribs broken, scratches. But Elaine was in a coma. Because after the explosion, she passed out and probably got hit by a couple of things, but little pieces, but not too serious. She just got into a coma, especially after that fog that went through, kind of messed up everybody. So Chad is just like, you know, at her bed, just like, blaming himself, you know, making this face like, oh my god, what happened? Why couldn't I just stop this?
You know, why do I have to show up for this day? And, you know, shit. Stuff went down, and apparently with this story, I'm trying to pitch it, but how am I going to do this with this video? This is crazy, but it's pretty interesting. So let's talk about how his action, you know, the action scene is him running towards Elaine, like, you know, trying to save his friend and stuff. But apparently with the story after the hospital, Chad recovers and stuff, and then he goes visit Elaine, you know, tries to comfort her or try to wake her up and stuff, you know, trying to see his friend, you know, make sure she's happy, safe, and her family will be okay with it. So her mom works at the hospital. Her father is I would actually go extend this with the story, but her father was supposedly working on a project which didn't go so well, because apparently people died from that, so he went into hiding. And there's a lot of lawsuits and a lot of things going on, of course, the news, the media, everybody's talking about it. Because what was, forget what the place is called, but later on in the story, Chad just visits Elaine, but he noticed there's a couple changes after the accident, you know. He got a little stronger and faster. For some reason, there's something different about him. And I guess he learns about it when he's like angry, frustrated, punching walls, and then all of a sudden he breaks them, crumbles to little pieces, showing his powers. It's like, whoa, what happened to me? Anyway, so he's pretty much like a mutant right now. Elaine's still in her coma, so he goes and visits her, and he reads old book while his mom, Elaine's mom is still testing her. So he comes in, reads a book, but she suddenly wakes up. This is where it goes crazy. Elaine kind of wakes up in a strange way, because she starts to fly up in the air, and there's like a wave of lightning. It's like destructive. Could think they're on a separate floor. And explosion. Another little explosion in the room has happened. But Chad was fast enough to cover Elaine's mom. No injuries. Not even Chad. Maybe a couple holes in the shirt after the shockwave. So, for some reason, Chad, there's nothing wrong. There's no scratches, not even on Elaine's mother, which is strange. So she kind of notices that. And she notices there's something wrong with her daughter too, but not in a bad way. So apparently these kids got gifted with something they could actually do good with. Because, you know, after Elaine wakes up, starts chatting up, because she's all screaming, "Chad, where are you?" And then, but, you know, Chad comforts her, and her mother comforts Elaine, like, "Now everything's fine, we're here," and stuff. There was a big accident, and from Starlight Corporation, something was going on, but let's not worry about that, pretty much what they told her. And then soon after that, they learned from the powers, because Elaine's mom actually helped by testing and controlling. So later on, they become superheroes, you know, keeping their identities undercover. But I would actually want to do more with the story, but this is pretty much what I have with the video and telling you guys how that's gonna be. This is probably gonna be funny, but hope you guys enjoyed it, and thank you for your time, and thanks.